A kite is a quadrilateral with two pairs of consecutive congruent sides. So these pair are congruent, and these pair are congruent. Now, just like a rhombus, the diagonals are perpendicular. And in fact, the formula is exactly the same as that of a rhombus. The area of a rhombus, or a kite, is 1/2 d1 times d2. You multiply the two diagonals, and then you take half of that. In this problem, they gave us the diagonals are 6 root 35 and 16 root 14. So 6 times 16 is 96, and half of 96 is 48. Now I'm looking at root 35 and root 14, and I notice that 35 and 14 both have a common factor of 7. In fact, 35 is 7 times 5, and 14 is 7 times 2. And the reason I did that is because the two 7s are going to make a perfect square of 49. This is 48 root 49 times 5 times 2. The square root of 49 will go out as a 7, and I'll take 7 times 48, which is 336. Left underneath the root is still the 5 and the 2, and 5 times 2 is 10. So our final answer is 336 root 10. Even though a kite has some of the properties of a rhombus, remember that a kite is not a rhombus. A rhombus has four pairs of congruent sides. A kite has two pairs of consecutive congruent sides. They're not all equal to each other, but they do have the same formula for the area, and they do have perpendicular diagonals, just like a rhombus. Don't forget the label. Centimeter, it's area, so it's centimeters squared.